through the internet to be able to share in this wonderful program of our children, as well as a baptism and communion this day. What a blessing of a day on this, the second Sunday of Advent. And this is just the beginning of things, because next Sunday our joint choir with Yellow Medicine are providing us with the blessings of Christmas in music. And then next Sunday evening we have the community Christmas dinner at 5, where everyone is invited. And the week after that is 4 Sunday in Advent in the morning, and Christmas Eve at 4 and 7 in the evening. So it will be lots of activity every week coming forward. But that's not all of it. I want to let you know a couple of other things coming forward here. Today we have the Christmas program, and then after church today, our kids are going to take their music up to the care center so that they can share the joy of the season with all those who are at the care center as well. And then those of you that have enjoyed the cookies, you should know that they were donated today by the confirmation kids who made them last week, last Wednesday, as part of their activities. So we give thanks to them for the cookies. And there is a sign-up sheet for anyone else who would like to sign up for the rest of December and January going forward. So make sure you do that. But we also, looking farther out into June of next year, we have two ladies who are planning on going to the National Youth Gathering, and they want to tell you a little bit about it. So, Evelyn and Vanessa.
Together here. light it again as we remember that Christ, who was born in Bethlehem, will come again to fulfill all of God's promises to us. The second candle of Advent is the candle of peace. The prophet Isaiah called Jesus Christ the Prince of Peace. When Jesus came, he taught people the importance of being peacemakers. He said, "Those who make peace shall be called the children of God." In these darkening days of Advent, we come seeking peace. We seek serenity or peace within ourselves. We seek peace within our families. We seek peace and goodwill among our neighbors. Peace is not the absence of conflict, but peace Jesus brings fullness to our lives. It is like solving a puzzle. Jesus' peace takes the scattered pieces of our lives and puts them in order. Peace is Christ's presence in the midst of our ever-turning world and lives. Peace is like light shining in a dark place. As we look at this candle, we celebrate the peace we find in Jesus Christ. Come, Jesus, Prince of Peace. Let us pray. Thank you, Jesus, for your presence in us and among us, and for the peace you give us. We ask that as we wait for all your promises to come to you, and for Christ to come again, that you would remain present with us. Help us today and every day to worship you, to hear your word, and to do your will by sharing your peace with each other. We ask this evening, the one who is born in heaven. Thank you.
This morning we shall go back more than 2,000 years to a dusty little town called Bethlehem. There we will meet Benjamin, an artist and matron, who helps his mama discover the wonder of the Bible, born in this life. Come with us now to share the wonder of that wonderful Christmas night.
Before sunset, and when I say clean, I mean clean. I want the cobwebs swept from the rafters, the old straw off the floor. When you put down new straw, don't forget to fill the manger. And no sloppy job. Do you hear it? I want these stables clean.
But why, Mama? It's only an old barn. Nobody sees it except the cows.
Don't you see, boy? There's so many people in town. I could probably rent out this place too. Now hurry, there are other jobs to do when you're done.
Do this, do that. All she ever thinks about is work and money, and money and work. I wish Ethan were here. He would understand. Tend the sheep, Ethan, is all his papa ever says. He can't understand that Ethan must make music, and I would rather not. Why can't older people understand there's more to life than work? Why can't they see the wonder in faces, and in stars, and in sunsets? Surely the Lord meant us to see more than cobwebs in a stable.
Thank you.
Well, aren't buns? Oh no, not sketching again. Now we have records for the stables and you aren't finished. I'm sorry, sir, but my son has not finished cleaning the stable.
That's all right. I think Mary must rest here anyway. She is tired from her long journey. She and her time are very near. We'll do quite here. Thank you. I was beginning to think you would find no shelter at home.
Oh, sir, she is so beautiful. Could I stay just a while longer and sketch her?
Maybe tomorrow, son. Maybe tomorrow. And now I think Mary needs to be alone.
No more sketching.
Is shining brightly tonight, such a lovely town.
Lovely, it's just a little village, always will be. But don't you remember the prophecy?
When you went back to heaven, all Bethrathma, who are one of the clans of Judah, for you shall not come forth for me, the one who is to rule in Israel. Whose partner is from a whole ancient age.
This is really a beautiful clear night. I've never seen the stars shine so brightly. This is truly a night made for music. Not now, Ethan. I'm tired. Let's go to sleep.
Oh,
what a play.
I like Ethan's music. I'll play if you'll sing. How about the song about staying awake and ready?
Listen, there is music on the wind. Do you hear it?
I don't hear anything. It must be your imagination.
Listen, it's only a whisper of a song now, but it seems to be getting louder. It's almost like angels singing through the trees.
Thank you.
shine brightly, and who is you?
Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people.
This baby.
In the city of David, you know Bethlehem.
This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger.
Let us go down to Bethlehem and see. This thing has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us.
Come on, Ethan, let's go find the baby.
Come on.
thing has happened.
I know, Ben. We were told by angels a baby has been born.
He's a special baby, Ethan, but I don't know why. I only know that when I look at him, I see the wonder in his eyes, and I feel the wonder in my heart. Who is he?
The angel said he is the Messiah that we have waited for. Think of it, Ben. The Savior who has been born, who has been set to free us from our sins. We have come to worship him.
Benjamin, Benjamin, where are you now? Don't you ever learn, boy. The sun is almost up, and here we are drawing again. Hurry now. That would mean nothing. We need wood for the fire. Who are all these people? I rented this room out to only two people. The rest will have to pay if they're going to take a room.
It's only Ethan and the other shepherds, Mama. But they have come to see the baby. Look at him, Mama. He's a special, wonderful gift from God.
I hope he grows up to be a credit to his mother, unlike some sons I know. And hurry up, there's lots to be done.
Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Bethlehem to Grand Falls, the Savior has come. Let us be glad and sing.
Listen to these and all our prayers, O God. of hosts, and restore us with your great and everlasting mercy. Please be seated. This service has an unusual order to it, so let us sing Jesus Loves Me, a hymn requested for Jett's baptism, as we now join in welcoming Jett to baptism.
Of the church. Do you renounce the forces and all of the forces that defy God. I renounce him. Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? I renounce them. And do you renounce the ways of sin and death that draw you away from God? I renounce them. And do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. And do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. Would you like to help poor Wander? Can you help me? Come up here. And together, we'll hold this. And go forward. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. And through the sea, you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river, your son Jesus was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Pour out your Spirit, O God, on this water, that is the baptism of Jesus and his death. You set us free from the power of sin and death, and you joined us to everlasting life in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are baptized here today, Jett, Robert, may be given the gift of new life. To you be given honor and praise and glory through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we hold Jett over the font. Jett Robert Lecy, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Sorry for the eyes, Jeff. Amen. You can hold that for me. Jeff Robert, you belong to Christ, in whom you have been baptized. Hallelujah. Let us pray. We give you thanks that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give your sons and daughters new birth. You cleanse them from sin and you raise them to life everlasting. Now I invite you to bring your chant here. Let us pray. Sustain Jett Robert with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, now and forever. Amen. Jett Robert. We forgot the candle, but we will have that for you. Jett Robert Lecy, let your light so shine before others that as you grow in years and faith, you may glorify your Father in heaven. Amen. And as a congregation, let us welcome Jett. We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission you share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and marry God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. Is it a lot of work to be a big sister? Do you help take care of him? What do you do? Do you hold him? He knows you. You're welcome. Yeah. Grand Falls Lutheran, we welcome Jett Robert. And we celebrate the gift of life, the gift of new beginnings, and the gift of generations and children. So, these are going to be your friends. Yeah. Look at them. Thank you. We will continue with Jesus Loves Me.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Eternal God, you make the desert bloom, and you send springs of water to the thirsty ground. Receive these simple gifts of bread, wine, money, and make us messengers of your mercy and messengers of your love for all in need of your healing and justice. We ask this through Christ our Savior. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. Our Lord Jesus, in the night in which he was betrayed, took bread, gave thanks and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body broken for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all, saying, "Take and drink. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, poured out for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." As often as we eat of the bread and drink of the cup, we remember our Lord's death until he comes again. Amen. And together, let us pray with confidence and boldness the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Come, celebrate the feast. All are welcome who believe in Jesus at the Lord's table, to feast with one another and be strengthened for your journey.
Thank you. Thank you.
I invite the congregation to please stand. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you forever in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. Faithful God, in this meal, you have remembered your mercy, bringing heaven to earth in the body and blood of Jesus. As we wait for the day when all of your promises will be fulfilled, sustain us and strengthen us by this holy mystery. Guide us towards your promised future, coming in the birth of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Receive God's presence and blessing as you go into the week that is ahead of you. May the God of peace bless you. May the love of Christ sustain you. May the hope and the anointing of the Holy Spirit remain with you and upon you now and forever. Amen. And we sing our sending hymn number 269, Once in Royal David City.
Thanks be to God.